Finch, how are you doing?
Good, how about you?
I tell you, Mr. Finch is my dad.
This is Bill.
How are you?
Good.
How's the city treating you?
So far, so good.
Good.
I'm
probably should have went back by the office a little bit. Okay, under acknowledgements, let me recognize a couple of people here that's running for political office tonight. Forsyth County Solicitor, we have a candidate, Bill Finch, is here. Bill, raise your hand. Glad to have you with us.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Also, Susan Zereini. Susan's here, running for Forsyth County Solicitor. Thank you all for being with us. Okay, under item A, we have Confederate History Month Proclamation. I'll read the proclamation, and this will be for the daughters of the Confederacy. Two here and one other. daughters of the Confederacy and the sons of the Confederate. Proclamation, Confederate History and Heritage Month, April 1st through the 30th, 2014, Cumming, Georgia. Whereas, April is the month in which the Confederate States of America began and ended its four-year struggle for states' rights, individual freedom, and local control, as did our Revolutionary War forefathers. And whereas, Confederate Memorial Day is a time when the city of Cumming honors the men and women who served the Confederate States of America. And whereas, the city of Cumming has a long cherished history, which includes that of the war between the states. And whereas, the citizens of Cumming, Georgia have contributed to this great country, and many men and women of this community have given their lives for freedom in many wars. And whereas, it is vital that the city of Cumming reflect on the heritage of the past and respect the devotion of the Southern leaders, soldiers, and others to the cause of the Southern independence. And therefore, do I proclaim the month of April 2014 as Confederate History and Heritage Month in the city of Cumming, Georgia, and encourage our citizens to become more knowledgeable of the role played by the Confederate States of America in the history of our great country. Hereunto set my hand and cause the seal of the city of Cumming to be affixed this 18th day of March in the year of our Lord 2014. Signed by myself as mayor of the city of Cumming. Will the women of the Confederate come forward for a picture, please?
Thank you.
having a meeting on this great call. We appreciate the work y'all do. Item 4, old business, Sanders Road, request from Forsyth County. This is a long-term issue that's been going on since April of last year. And county has, after the city's numerous counters with them, they have sent back another counter to the city. And I will basically give you the nuts and they have proposed, this was sent from Ken Rod as an attorney for the county letter, which basically requested the city's proposal from our last meeting. To try to resolve the issue on Sanders Road. It's an issue that needs to be taken care of. It needs, the citizens need that road, Buford Dam and Meredith Park Road. And we want to do everything that we can to try to resolve it, get the road fixed as far as the city of Cumming is concerned. It's a county road project, and we have related that to the county, and they have requested mediation on behalf of resolving the issue. So I would recommend to this board that authorize the city attorney to notify the council, the commissioners, that the city is willing to go the extra mile and do whatever necessary to try to resolve the issue. So I'd recommend that we mediate this issue with the county. So do you have anything to add to that, Mr. Banner?
That's right. We'll need a vote from the council one way or the other. That's my recommendation as well as the joint meeting.
Chair, I entertain a motion to authorize the council attorney to go report to the commissioner's attorney that we're willing to go into mediation prior to resolve Sanders Road issue.
I make a motion that we do that.
Second, in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Item B is speed tables at Ridgecrest-Brooks Farm Drive. Our engineering firm had requested when they did the test on those roads, two roads, to decide what to do with them. One of the things was to put speed tables when they done the survey and put speed tables on it. That's what the council approved at our last meeting. The engineering firm had requested that put up four speed tables on that road. Gerald Blackburn had talked to the staff and the engineering and the street department and so forth. And Gerald, I think you have a recommendation in reference to that.
Yes, we've talked with the people out there, a good many of the people out there, and we're going to be doing some paving in that general area, assuming it is passed later in the meeting. And what the street department and several of the people that we've talked to was to put in, based on the engineering that was done, and they showed four of the speed tables to be located in different areas out there as their highest recommendation. And what we're proposing is to do two of those speed tables and make sure that the residents in that area is pleased with the way they are working. And that's while some of the paving is being done out there, and then come back and everybody's happy. We're looking at putting in the other two is was drawn in the drawings at, if everybody's happy, at a later date while some of that paving's still going on out there.
Okay. I might add on that, I think one of the things that most of the residents on that road were concerned about was the fact that the three-way stop sign there, that people wasn't honoring that three-way stop sign. So I would go along with it too, recommend that we go along with the staff's recommendation, but two speed tables there, and one of them will be on Ridgecrest from the intersection of Camilla and Ridgecrest, go 175 feet from that intersection, but the first speed table, and also from that intersection on Brooks Farm Drive, Camilla, go 180 feet, and that will get it close to that intersection on both of those and have the traffic to slow down. So that would be my recommendation to the board to put two in.
Is that from Bill to Bill, 180?
No, from the intersection of Ridgecrest and Brooks Farm.
Right.
Go north on that road. And it'll go west from the intersection back toward 9. So the recommendation from staff is put two in. Chair, entertain a motion.
I make a motion.
Our motion, have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify. Any discussion? All in favor, signify. Now, you raise your hand. Who all voted? Dundee, Lewis, Quincy. All opposed? All opposed. Okay. Item B, recreation and parks. We have Greg Little here in reference to the spring and summer brochure. Greg? No, I'm missing. I got you out of line, Greg, if you would. I'm sorry. Wait just a minute. I missed administrative. We have Roy Cole here with the audit report, and that's for information only, and this will be acted on at the next meeting, which will be the April Riker meeting.
Yes, sir.
This is for information only. Great.
The audit staff is here for you to look at for a month, and we'll come back to the April meeting and give you a presentation.
That's good. Thank you, John. Okay, item two. We city's insurance thank you April 1st. I think we have a representative from the insurance company, Gail Petrie, again. Gail.
Only. And this year, the 15 units that we added to the policy were all brand new units and carry full coverage. So that's the main difference in the increase in premiums in auto. Everything else stayed relatively the same, and all of the coverages are identical to what we had other than the addition of tourism.
The flood and earthquake insurance is about $17,000 in addition to the $170,000 premium. Is that correct?
Exactly. Yes. The flood coverage, to include flood coverage, would be an additional $14,722. And to add earthquake, which up until a few weeks ago when we thought we needed it, earthquake is an additional $2,356.
It's up to the board whether you want the additional coverage on the other or not. Obviously, it is mandated that we get coverage on comparable to what we had last year, but this wasn't included last year. It's not included now, but it's an option. If you want to hold that. And you haven't. You have to give us, you just give us that as an option.
Yes, sir. Exactly. I do that each year just in case you decide at any point you want to add that coverage. Sure. So we welcome to do so.
This flood insurance, what have we got in the flood zone that requires flood insurance?
Well, that's just it. If anything is actually in a flood zone, that's going to be covered. It won't be covered by this particular coverage. That is actually something you get through the government, through flood insurance through the government. So anything that's actually in a flood zone is going to be covered by the state. This is, you know, a lot of times with the rain that we're getting in Georgia nowadays, you know, you can get flooding even though something's not necessarily in a flood zone.
We haven't had that.
Just been an option. And we've had a lot of rain, so I mean, just judging on historically speaking, we really haven't needed it, but it is available.
Okay, since we haven't had it in the past and we've got everything else covered there, that always comes up every year anyway.
Yes, sir, it does. And you have the option to add it at any time.
So we got a recommendation from staff and their agent of $170,043, and this is selective. And we also have another bid, which is Travelers Insurance, and their premium was $276,891. Basically, that it's no brainer there which one we're going to choose. I don't think.
Let's add flood, I'm not flood, but the earthquake to it, that's only $200 a month. So we will look at that on $400. Mm-hmm. We have flood if needed.
That's what I was just fixing to say. If during the year, if you feel like, you know, maybe we are having some unseasonably crazy rain events and you're noticing that there might be some areas within the city that might be prone to have some flood damage, we can always add it midterm. Okay. If they'll just prorate the premium.
Okay, what's special is forward. We have $170,043 plus $2,356 for earthquake coverage.
Motion to renew the quotes.
Second for John Day. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Okay, we have some roads up for resurfacing. We have Jason McCook here with the engineering department for their proposal. Jason.
We received three bids for the resurfacing for this lane. Those bids came in. The low bid was $147,676.09. We reviewed the other two bids, and we reviewed actually all three bids, but we recommend the low bid.
The low bid was, the three bids was from Allied paving contractors, and Jasper Graven pipelines, and who was the other Baldwin, they were calling paving, and the low bid was $147,000.
Yes, sir.
$676, and it was Jasper.
Yes, sir.
That's your recommendation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have a recommendation from the engineer department, $147,676, and that includes North Connors Parkway, which is the road just above Ingles that goes to Cubsacks at Catholic House.
Yes.
The health department. We also have Mountain View Drive, which is from State Route 20 West to Trail Gap Road.
Correct. Yes, sir.
And that includes shoulder restoration. I noticed on that road, that was one of the big things that Councilman Ledbetter had talked about. They had a lot of water problems on that road, so we'll be sure to get the shoulder restoration on that road taken care of. And also Elm Street, this says State Route 20 to Triple Gap Road, but we're talking about State Route 19 to Triple Gap Road.
Yes, sir, it'll go from, actually it'll go from Triple Gap Road to State Route 9.
Oh, okay. Yeah. And look, I was looking at my page here, and it says Elm Street, State Route 20 to Triple Gap. It should be State Route 9.
It should be State Route 9.
All right, what's the pleasure of the board? Have a recommendation, $147,676.90.
We're getting a little state money, aren't we?
State gave us $51,000 for these projects. That's maintenance money.
That's the motion.
I'll second the motion.
We got a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, folks. Thank you. Now, item B, Greg, spring and summer brochure bids.
Thank you, Mayor. The Recreation Department is getting ready, gearing up for its big summer season. And accordingly, we are we have solicited and received bids for the printing of our programming brochure, which is a 24-page, 8.5x11 brochure that includes all of our class offerings, as well as copies of the trifold color brochure that we will distribute through the school. The bids that were sent out requested bids for 2,000 copies of the brochure, 23,000 copies of the trifold brochure for the Recreation Department, and 34,500 copies of the trifold brochure for the Aquatic Center. As you can see in the packet, we received two bids back. One from American Printing in Alpharetta, which was $7,759. And the second one from Graphic Edge in Cumming for $12,659.98. We are recommending that the low bid of $7,759 from American Printing be accepted. American Printing has printed our brochures and our flyers in the past and always done a good job in that way.
Okay, how did that compare to last year's?
Well, it's a little bit different this year. In the past, we have distributed approximately 24,000 of the 24-page brochures to the schools. The schools keep getting more kids in them, and we keep offering more programming, and we're just not sure that's a cost-effective way to advertise our programs this year. So we're going to the trifold brochure reduce costs, to get basically just a nutshell of what we offer at the Red Department, and then allow everybody to go to our online brochure, actually see what we have to offer there instead of printing 24,000 copies of the 24-page brochure throughout the school. So this is the first year we've actually done it this way, so we'll see how it works for us.
We have a recommendation from the board that go with American Printing Company out of Alpharetta, Georgia, second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Greg.
Thank you, Mayor.
Okay, item three, city park renovation. This is a project that we have been talking about and staff has been working on for some time. And Greg has the recommendation from the board in reference to the next process and demolition of the old city park.
Yes, sir, I do have that. We had the also the purchase of the parallel bars for the gymnastics. Is number two. If I can do whichever order you decide.
Sorry, let's go with number two. Okay. Parallel bars.
Thank you, Mayor. The Recreation Department has solicited and received bids for a set of uneven bars for the gymnastics program at the Dobbs Creek Recreation Center. The set of bars that we are currently using has been there since the opening of the rec center and recently have been in a constant state of repair and have become a major safety concern for us. So we have solicited bids to replace that equipment. We received three bids in, one from East Coast Gym Supply in Kentucky for $5,400, Elite Athletic Sports Equipment in Tennessee for $5,560, and the Equipment Guy from Buford, Georgia for $5,710. We are actually, even though we've got a low bid of $5,400, we are recommending that we go with the second lowest bid from Elite Athletic Sports Equipment, $5,560. We had some issues in getting the bid from East Coast Supply in that they would never give us a definite definitive price for the freight and shipping on the cost of that to get that to us. We tried to pin them down. They gave us an estimate of $150, but said that it could be more than that. Elite Athletic Sports Equipment gave us a definitive quote on the shipping and handling freight charges, and have also offered to not only deliver the equipment, but also install it for us. So our recommendation, and Elite Athletic Sports has, we have equipment from them in the past. The equipment has been reliable and they're a relatively good company to work for us to work with. So that is our recommendation.
The recommendation is a second highest bid, which looks like it's about $160.
$160.
And that can fluctuate. That bid is fixed, but the other bid with $160 cheaper can fluctuate more.
That's right. And we get free installation.
So conceivably it can be cheaper.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right, what's the pleasure of the board? Mm-hmm. Have a recommendation from an Elite Athletic Sports Equipment out of Clarksville, Tennessee. None of them were local.
No. The closest one we had was Equipment Guy in Buford, and we have not dealt with him in the past.
I'm glad to know that. $5,560. This was, I might say, was in the budget for this year for these cars. Have a motion. Have a second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, Gary. Now, City Park renovation.
All right, Mayor. We are in order to prepare for the renovations that are fast approaching for coming City Park. We have solicited and received bids for the demolition and removal of the current structures in the park. These include the buildings there, the light poles, the swimming pool building, basically all structures, all concrete, everything in the park needs to be removed before the renovations can really begin. So we have solicited those bids. We received three bids. From Reed Contractors, $92,301.96. That is for the complete project. From Jasper Grading Company, we received a bid of $128,300. That bid was for the complete project, all the structures. We also received a bid from Junior Ray Brown Concrete of $38,110, but that was for only three items that were on the overall project. That was the removal of the sidewalks, the removal of the concrete driveway, the removal of the tennis courts. His breakdown of those prices was was more than the prices compared from either Jasper Gray or Reed Reed. So it is our recommendation that we go with the overall low bid of $92,301.96 from Reed Reed Contractors.
And every one of them was that bid, or the two that bid on all, they bid on the same thing.
That's correct. Everything was identical.
Both bids were identical.
Yes, sir.
And the low bid, which was $38,000, only bid on three items.
That's correct. Only three items, and the breakdown in the other two bids, he was higher than either one of those two bids on those three items.
And that would get us started on the demolition of the old park.
We started removing fences and those kind of things, and we're getting the ball field lights off the poles, but this is what it's not here.
Okay, the recommendation from staff is $92,301.96 for Reed and Reed. What's the time frame on getting that done?
Well, they are, Georgia Power is removing or disconnecting all power to the buildings and removing the transformers in the park at this time. They got one of the transformers and about half the park disconnected today. Should be able to get the rest of it done by the end of the week. So, we'll be ready to then start work next week. As soon as they mobilize their equipment and get it in there.
Council, have any questions? Okay, recommendation. So Reed and Reed at $92,301.96. Chair, entertain a motion.
I make a motion.
Have a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, Greg. Okay. The bid for the geotech firm for scope of the work as far as the site work.
That's correct, Mayor. We have solicited and received proposals for the geotechnical services to determine the subsurface ground composition at the park. We received six bids, which will include borings and pit samplings. Those bids range from $2,300 as a low bid to $5,550 as a high bid. The low bid was from Oasis Consulting Services of Roswell for $2,300. We have looked at the proposals from all six companies. They were all competitive and comparing the same thing. So we are recommending that we go with the low bid of $2,300 from Oasis to provide the geotechnical services at the park. Another advantage is we think that they will be able to mobilize maybe a little bit quicker to get that done than some of the other ones.
I'm looking at your bid tabulation here. You had six bidders and Oasis. None of them was from the city, not coming from South County.
That's right.
So the closest one, I guess, was Roswell, which was the cheapest one, Oasis Consulting Services.
That's right.
$2,300. So.
And they were $1,600 less than the next lowest bid.
Okay, what's the pleasure of the board? Have a motion for question. Have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Unanimous. Thank you, Greg. Okay, item C, appointment of handy architects on a design. This is for professional service and design.
That's correct. This is professional services for the design of the park and the design of the buildings and basically the entire project. We were recommending that handy architects and design be awarded this. I guess it's not really a bid, but we give them this design. Well, we hired to provide the design services for the city park project.
Okay, we have a recommendation for the professional services and design be awarded to Handy Architect and Design Incorporated, and they are local, right?
That is correct, they are local.
Okay, Chair entertain a vote, motion.
Make a motion.
Have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand, get out, and thank you very much. Okay, item C, under family zoning, we have a zoning request, 201411, Marco LePay, public hearing, please.
Scott?
Yes, sir, Mayor.
You'll address the information you have, the owner has paid application to zone approximately 45 acre tract located at the intersection of Galena Highway and Brooks Farm Drive, from office professional to single-family residential, R1, for the purpose of constructing a single-family detached residence. To the best of our knowledge, the proposed rezoning would not be detrimental to the surrounding property owners' value, use, or enjoyment of their properties. The proposed rezoning is in conformance with the City of Cumming Council of Future Land Use Plans. The Planning and Zoning Board held a public hearing on February 18th, and with no stated opposition, unanimously recommended approval of this rezoning request with the following two conditions. Number one, the owner agrees to donate 12 and a half feet of property along Brooks Farm Drive to the city, be used for additional public right-of-way. And number two, the owner agrees to use the existing driveway on Galena Highway to access this property. That was the recommendation of conditions by the Planning and Zoning Board that this item will require a public hearing.
Okay, I hear a motion to open for a public hearing.
Make a motion.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, anybody want to speak in favor of zoning application 201411?
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, I'm in the list, and I'm here on behalf of Marco LePay in this request. And Mr. LePay is in agreement with the recommendation of the Planning Commission, and she has had the plan drawn to show the 12 and a half feet of property along Brooks Farm Drive to be used as additional public right-of-way, and she is agreeable to use the existing driveway on the Galena Highway to access her property. She plans to build a residence there for us.
Again, the council have any questions? Thank you, anybody else like to speak in favor? Have anybody like to speak in opposition? I hear motion to close public hearing.
I make a motion.
Second? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. The recommendation of the Planning and Zoning Board is to request rezoning of 201411 Marco LePay. As presented, what's the pleasure of the board?
I make a motion that we do it.
I hear a motion from Lewis that the request be granted to zoning request, rezoning request 201411 Marco LePay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Item 2, annexation request 204150, Georgia 400 Industrial Park. Scott?
Yes, sir. Mayor, again, we'll address the information of staff report. The property owner has made application to annex 9.32 acres of land, more or less, in the city corporate limits, and rezone it from county commercial business district to city highway business district. To the best of our knowledge, the requested annexation and the rezoning will not be detrimental to the surrounding property owners' value, use, and enjoyment of their properties. Forsyth County has stated they have no objection to the proposed annexation. That letter is in your packet. The requested highway business zoning after you annex would be in conformance with the City of Cumming Comprehensive and Future Land Use Plans. The Planning Board did hold a public hearing on this matter on February 18th, and with no state opposition, unanimously recommended approval of the requested annexation and rezoning the highway business. I would mention this property is dump and storage, which is located at the intersection of Hillside Drive and Highway Dump. And this item will also require a public hearing, and our recommendation would be, of course, that you annex first and then rezone.
Okay, I hear a motion open for public hearing.
I have a motion.
Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Anybody here like to speak in zoning to, in favor of annexation request 2014-105? I want to state your name for the record, please.
I operate 4400 storage on that property. 35-year-old family business in the same location. It's the third generation that's down there now. We intend to maintain and operate the business in the same way that we have for the last 35 years, carefully growing it. And we just feel as though that we are more than a match for the city of Cumming. Most of our neighbors, the hospital, and the city of Cumming. And we really do look forward to being considered in the city.
Thank you. I'm sure anybody got any questions? Thank you very much. Anyone else like to speak in favor of zoning annexation request 2014-105? Anybody like to speak in opposition? Motion to close public hearing. Second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Okay, the annexation request, what's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion.
I have a motion from Rupert for annexation. Second from Willis. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, the rezoning request, what's the pleasure of the board? Motion John Day, now second. Points the end of the all in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item B, police department. Item one, computer replacements. Chief Taylor.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Council. What this is replacement of some computer that's still using the Windows XP operating system. Last year, the IT department identified these computers. Microsoft no longer supports XP as of April this year. So what we need to do is replace the computers so we don't jeopardize the security element and that kind of thing, so we avoid viruses and shut down our system, basically. We store a lot of critical data that we can't afford to be compromised. The quote we got from the city of WG for these computers is for both laptop computers, which are three of them are for cufflinks that go in cars, designed to withstand the vibration and moving around in cars, and one laptop that's inside the office. It's just a normal laptop, and then two workstations, one for our communications center and then one for the deputy chief cook. This is all the components, everything that we're going to need, software, everything we're going to need to change these computers out so that they're covered by Microsoft support. And the total purchase price on everything is $8,628.30. Like I said, we did budget for this in a year. We just need to go ahead and and help us purchase those replacements.
Question, every year we have to keep updating computers and this kind of thing. I noticed they're requesting payment Chicago, Illinois. Do we not have any closer people that wants to give bids on this kind of thing?
The problem is getting the design, or get the tough books for cars, and most of the time you can get a package deal better if you buy more than just one computer here, one computer there, you buy several of them at a time, all we have to do. The tugboats are unique. They have to go in the cars, and a normal laptop computer won't last very long anymore. So that was the best price that we found on the tugboat.
How many? You're talking about three units?
Yes, sir.
$8,628.30. I know we did budget some money for it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Council, have any questions? What's the pleasure of the board? Recommendation from the department that update the computer to arrive at that cost is $8,628.30.
I'll make a motion.
Have a motion, have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Chief. Thank you. Okay, item A, utilities department. Mr. Hurd, John Hurd.
Mayor, members of the city council. As you know, the Georgia DOT is planning to widen Highway 20 from Sanders Road to Chattahoochee River. And they've left that project. The project has begun, and they've requested to move utilities out of the way of the roadway widening project. The first request that we have is to advertise for bids for the Eccles Road, Highway 20, Horse Main, and Gravitt Sewer. These lines are in the way of the road widening project. And in this case, the DOT is providing funds to reimburse us for the movement, to move these lines and put them in a new easement outside the right way.
And we've got to do the job before the DOT will reimburse, right?
That's correct.
All right, we have a request to advertise for bids for Acknowledgements Road, State Route 20 East, Horse Main, and Gravity Sewer to be reimbursed by DOT. What's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion.
Have a motion, have a second.
Second.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, sir. Okay, item two, request to advertise for bids for State Route 20 East from Sample Grove to the river for a 60-inch water line.
Similarly, this is the water line along Highway 20. The DOT, of course, is widening the highway and expanding the right of way. So we're going to be forced to move our existing water line out of the right of way and out of the way of the roadway. It'll be quite a bit of grading. Some of the steep banks on the sides of the road will be cut down. Some of the lower, say, valleys along this roadway will be filled in. So we've got to work hand in hand with the Georgia DOT in that process. We don't want to dig down deeper than we have to. Looking for maybe some of the grading completely. So we're requesting that we be able to advertise for bids for a new 16-inch water line from Sample Road to pretty much to the Chattahoochee River Club entrance. And this is a project that we budgeted for in this year's budget. It is not something that the DOT will reimburse.
Okay. This is something that we got to do. Tie everything together and all the utilities and furnish the southern part of the county.
What size land you got down there now?
It's different sizes. Majority of it's a 12-inch line. Some of it's 8-inch line, so 16-inch line is the line required by the city's water master plan, which was a study that the engineering firm did to make sure that we have adequate fire flows and water supply to the farthest reaches of the service area.
So we need to get it all on a big line.
Yes, we do.
And basically, this is required by the DOT due to the fact that they're matching up the four-lane and six-lane roads all the way from Georgia Knoll. They would match up with the four-lane on State Route 20 West.
That's correct.
So what's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion.
Have a motion by John Day. Have a second.
Second.
Any questions? Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, John.
Thank you, Mayor. Members of the city council.
Okay, under announcements, we have a park head meeting April the 10th. 9 a.m. in the lower level of the city hall meeting facility. Item B is to April 19th. I'd also add that Costco had informed me that they'll be having a groundbreaking. They haven't given me the date, but Crystal, I will notify you whenever we get the date on official groundbreaking for Costco. We've been working on that project for about 2 years, so we finally purchased the property and the process of constructing, and they tell us that they'll be open real soon, but we have a purchase. And any other business come for this board? I hear motion to adjourn.
Make a motion.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Hey, Pat?
I'll be right back. Shopping business.